Let us just look at the importance of spirituality in daily life. Since our childhood, under normal condition, we are trained for everything. We are trained to eat. We are trained to drink. We are trained to walk. We are trained to talk. We are trained into language skills. We are taken to creche and from there to play schools and from there to schools, like that. And we are trained for everything, everything, everything. And it's our parents who take us to different, who take us through different stages of growth. If you go and ask any gentleman under normal conditions, particularly in Delhi, Bombay, etc., are you doing something about your children's spiritual education? They'll say, what? Religion? No, no way. Religion is out of woe. Religion is out of passion. And if there is somebody who has some sensibility, will say, that's for old age. Worse, they will say that religion will be my child's personal choice. You mean all your ancestors were stupid? India has been training its kids since its very childhood into religion and spirituality. Once a child was 7-8 years old, roughly, he used to be given sacred thread. And he was given Gayatri Mantra. And he was taught how to do three sandhya. And he was taught how to do Gayatri Mantra. And it was compulsory, it was mandatory for every dvija. Dvija means twice born. That means people who did not want to follow these principles were considered Shudra. And Manu very clearly says that Shudras should be encouraged to come in the mainstream and behave like Dvija. That means if they want to take Gayatri Mantra, of course, not many of the preachers will agree with what I am saying, but Manu is very clear about it, that the unification of the society has to come by pulling people up and not by pulling people down. What we are seeing today is, see, everybody is asking for reservations. Everybody says that I want to be in OBC, I want to be in SC and ST. Somewhere you say that, well, SC and ST and OBC, these are the higher things. But as we have seen traditionally from the society, that they were not given certain rights from the society, and most importantly, they were not given the right to perform sacred thread, that is Yajnopavit, Janeu, and they were not given Gayatri Mantra. But a person like Manu wanted that everyone should have it. But then it cannot be done. He was not a believer into radicalism. He won't do anything violently, he won't do it overnight. But the Dvij, at least those who were twice born, those who belong to the higher society, it was must for them to be initiated into Gayatri Mantra, and it was must for them to perform Gayatri Mantra a set number of times, so that as he grows, he continues with that practice, and he continues with more and more of religion, so that once he's around 50, in those days 50 was a pretty old age, although it's not pretty old age today, that by 50 he can withdraw his mind from the world and devote himself entirely to God. Just look at the suffering everywhere. Just look at the thing that you are getting in the social media. Just look at the things that's happening all around. Just read the newspapers. It's pathetic. It's breaking down. Entire system is breaking down. Young ones are having traumatic experiences in life. Molestation is rampant. It's just getting rampant. And depression is there. Drug abuse is there. You name the thing, alcoholism is there. Rash driving is there. And total indiscipline is there. In one word, if you want to explain what is happening to India, you can say total breakdown of discipline. There is no discipline anywhere, neither in the home, nor in the schools, nor in the street, nowhere, nowhere, nowhere. Try telling anybody something, he will say, Gyan mat do, don't preach me. Without realizing that they are becoming basmasur and they are moving towards their own disaster. And why? Because their mind is not calm. Their mind is not coordinated. Their mind is not channelized. Mind can be channelized only through discipline. And the most important discipline in life has been education. Spiritual education is part of that education. Whatever those seculars or whatever they are and liberals and they may talk about, they're forgetting the basic thing that a man, as Jesus said, a man will not live by bread alone. And we are seeing the disastrous outcome of, disastrous consequences of moving away from the higher values of life. It's a very simple thing. Do you want values or you don't want values? Do you want to be eaten alive once you leave your home and go to the streets? Do you want the kind of shootings, etc., that is going on in America every now and then? We hear that some disgruntled youth, some frustrated person, he opened fire in a restaurant, in school. Do you want this? Do you want that we live like a civilized people, whatever the civilized definition of civilization be for you and for me? Civilization basically means self-control. You need to control yourself. You cannot allow your passions, your violent things to be expressed in public. It's your private affair, keep it private. Some people are telling that religion is a private matter and passion is a public matter. Things that we had never imagined to take place at Belur Math, now we are seeing those things. Young people coming, embracing and this and that. Unthinkable. We were taught, I mean India has taught its children since childhood to be private about passions and be public about it, their religion. Things have turned, says religion is my private affair and passion is my public affair, and see the consequences. It is just the beginning. It's only the soft wind blowing. The tornado is coming from behind. And see the destruction that's going to come. And the way indiscipline ultimately laid India down. And there were 1,000 years of Islamic rule and 200 years of British rule, and there were killings and brutal. See, I am not against British rule or Islamic rule or this and that. What I am telling that people suffered. Why? Because discipline was lost. People who were supposed to defend the country did not defend the country well. And the country suffered. Thousands and thousands of innocents died at the blade of swords. And their only fault was that they were inhabitants of this land, Hindus. The only fault for them was that they were Hindus. When people are talking about today, you know, we keep on hearing things. We keep on reading things, we keep on hearing about casteism, we keep on hearing about the exploitation of different castes. But have you ever heard that some caste was burned to death simply because they belonged to that caste? No. There were economic factors, there were social factors, there was some kind of injustice involved. If the upper caste was killed, some kind of injustice was there, and if the lower castes get killed, it's invariably some kind of economics involved. But when foreign religions come and foreign powers come, they kill us simply because for being what we are, an Indian, a Hindu. And how could these people come and entrench themselves? Only because people were not disciplined at that time. And I can assure you, I have a feeling, and Swami Vivekananda has also said, that there is an imminent fear of an attack from outside forces. It will be there because we are not disciplined. Discipline shows in morality. And the biggest and the most powerful thing that governs morality is religion and spirituality. You just cannot define morality on your basis. Like Moses. He was a great prophet and he just gave commandments. He had the divine power by God where he could command and said that these are the commandments and my people have to follow it. Who has given these commandments for the Indians? Who has given these commandments for the Hindu race? No one. So our life was governed by certain value system, certain code. We are supposed to be great people. We are supposed to be good Hindus by practicing values. Religion is the primary need of human beings. Religion is the primary need of India. It needs to be taught since very childhood. We need to be trained, and it is the duty of every grown-up person to train oneself into the values of religion and then train the next of the generation. People say we will take diksha, we will take initiation when we get old, when you will have power for... You can't even control your bodily movement at that age, and you think that you will control your mind by repeating the name of God at that age. What a stupid thing. And it's a very simple thing. If you want your destruction, because a morally corrupt person becomes a decadent society. Just look at the history of Rome. Just look at the history of any of those countries. They became decadent because they were not following religion anymore. They were not following morality anymore. Unless we do something about it, unless we start studying Gita, sacred book like Gita, unless we started studying religious books like Ramayana and all, and unless we make our students go for spiritual education from their very childhood, and their spiritual education, the way we train them into education, we train them into language, we train them into science, exactly that way they need to be trained into spiritual sciences. Spirituality is a science. They need to be trained. And if you are not good enough to train, go find the right teacher. And don't look at the stray cases of aberration, when you find that this Baba has landed into jail and that Baba has landed into jail. Remember that fake coins run only where there are real coins. Nobody is going to have fake dollars in India. Fake dollars can run only in America. Currency of India is rupee. Here will be only fake rupees. The moment you find that there are fake Babas, it only shows that there are real Babas. It only shows that spirituality is very much real in India. And because spirituality sells, and spirituality is very much truth, and spirituality is way of life in India, and that's why we have these kind of people who are faking spirituality. That shows we need to get serious about spirituality. We need to get deeper into it. Sooner we do, the better.